Hello, hello, hello. So yeah, I don't expect there to be a lot of people today because I blocked all my social media. Because I am studying for, it's like the content exam for science teachers in Georgia, which I was like, it's not that big of a deal. I know science. And then I'm studying for, I'm like, shit, this is basically comps. But for teachers, I underestimated this test. So my brain is melting. But in order to give myself the time to actually study, I blocked all my social media until the test next week. And so I have no place to post all the things. Yay! I might be able to tweet it on my phone. Yeah, let's actually do that, because that's... I'm going to do that real quick while you sit here and watch me. Let's watch me tweet! And somehow I hit Pandora. Okay, so I tweeted it. That's my one social media that isn't blocked on my phone because I don't have Twitter installed on my phone. I use the mobile website on my phone. And I didn't block the internet browser. And more specifically, what I did was I uninstalled all the apps, and I can't uninstall at least the default internet app. So there's always a way for me to do that, to post. Anyway, so what have we got? We've got stuff. Stuffity stuff stuff. And yeah, I'm just looking at all the things. Excellent. Really wish there was a Braves game on right now. That would be very nice background music. But there is no Braves game today. Oh well. I think it's like Thursdays are travel days or something. I don't know. No, there was a game last week. I don't know. I don't know how this works. So if there's no one here, this usually makes it a very chill stream where it's basically I just write. Okay, what do we got first? Nemosine Halley's Comet. So that's actually the last one in this box. And then I'm done with this box. It's a milestone. Like, in theory, I've done 3 boxes worth of things. Because I've also done new ones as they've come in. But really, it's only like the second completely full box. So yeah, this one took a while because I like got a bunch of new inks while I was in the middle of this box. So I've been working on that box, this box of samples since like November. Because I got like 20 new ink samples in the midst of it that I paused for them. Since I do 2 a week, that's 10 weeks. That's like 2 months worth of ink samples extra. In the middle. In our classic struggle with a Goulet sample. This is going to be one of those, like, kind of like Schaefer Purple, like a couple weeks ago. Where it was, or even that one, no, that was 2 weeks ago. What am I doing? Where it was like, this looks cool, but it's not that hot. Oh my god. To give you an idea, though, of like how much I've been studying, I basically today like the last 2 days, and this is day three. It's basically I've been doing a semester of physics of college per day. So like Tuesday was everything mechanics. Yesterday was fluids and also E&M. Today is finishing off E&M and then optics. Which that took longer because I forgot how complicated magnets are. And I don't know if the assessment, because it's for high school level. I don't have a high school level physics book. I have my college level physics book. And I'm like, well, that's over preparing. But I remember distinctly that though you could do, a lot of E&M is hampered by the fact that you don't know calculus yet when you do it in high school. But I do know calculus. And so, and my calculus in my physics book is calculus based. So it's a lot heftier chapters than what is probably needed. But I forgot how much I like learning and math physics and stuff. And so this was a nice little thing. I was like, oh yeah, you do like this stuff. You're a nerd. All right, my pencil sharpener is in the other room to go with all the stuff. Most of my stationery, so my desk here in this room has been like my work desk. Like I can do like work, like jobby work here, but like I have like zero focus doing like school type, academic type work at this desk. So that is my kitchen table. My kitchen table is my academic desk. And so I moved a bunch of my stuff out there. It's just like a war zone. Anyway. Yeah, but yeah, I burned through a Lamy converter in 2 days, full of ink. Actually, let's tweak this a little bit. I'm tweaking the tags a little bit. If people aren't joining me, then I'm going to turn on the auditory ASMR. Because, yeah. I should probably show you the swatch color, right? Ironically, last night I was looking up the worksheet, the like guide of what to study is very strange to me because they were like, yeah, periodic motion, including pendulums, cool, oscillating harmonic motion, cool, then like planetary motion and orbits, which. Yes, those are circular and periodic motion, but that's like a whole other chapter in my physics textbook. Like, that's like Kepler's laws and gravitational force and all that stuff. I'm like, this is under the same bullet point as like simple harmonic motion? No? So some of these bullet points, I'm like, oh yeah, it's one bullet point. Usually like part of a chapter. This is like two chapters in one bullet point, two hefty chapters. Oh yeah, and they were like, yeah, DC currents and AC currents, one bullet point. I'm like, that's like three fucking chapters. And it's like magnets, like magnetism, electromagnetism. I'm like, that is three chapters. These bullet points are not proportional to the amount of information in them. Like some of them I just like burn through, and some of them it's like, holy shit, I spent 2 hours on this one bullet point. Anyway, swatch. Swatchy, swatch, swatch. So, Nemosine Halley's Comet. Like, 2 years ago or something, when these Nemosine inks first came out, I ordered a bunch of samples of them and then never actually tried them. So, we had the... Well, no, I did the orange. I did try the orange one right away. And that's actually... I used that one right away. I did that one several... Like, 2 or 3 months ago. So, Nemosine Halley's Comet. It looked like a much richer orange, I remember, on the Goulet website. Or orange, red, or purple, I can speak. But it's much, it's like the Iroshizuku, it's like the Diamine, it's like the Schaefer, it's like this kind of purple that is just not good to me. Private Reserve Purple Mojo, I actually really like, That's because if you can see in the writing, this is pale, weak sauce. This is punchy. And then Parfum Violet. This shit, I don't like. It smelled and it was super feathery. But I also swatched this while at. While staffing a table at a pen show. So that might not have been the best move. Anyway. This is Nemosine Halley's Comet. Let's get writing, shall we? Took me a while to pick out a thing that I wanted. So far, the ink is lovely, which is in contrast. I've stuck the orange Nemosine ink in this pen before, and it is super dry. So this is a nice contrast. Good to know it's not all the Nemosine inks, just the one. Thank you. This is doing the same thing the other one did, where it like goes down a little bit pinker, but then dries a little bluer. There it is. Yeah, this one's drying less pale than the Schaefer. Yes, sometimes they look in the swabs. I actually prefer this to the Schaefer Purple in terms of color. Won't make me buy a bottle. I just don't like this shade purple that much. Actually, pretty good feathering performance on this one. Maybe it's just these purples in general aren't bad. And it's always usually terrible at that, except for this one. That one was just so good. But yeah. Yeah, pretty good performance. Okay, so we're done with that one. Which means I'm gonna empty these, and after I do that, okay, then this box has been officially all reviewed. We're moving on to box 3 next. I'll be right back in like 10-15 minutes. I'm just gonna go clean these pens real quick. Okie dokie. Hello, I'm back. Oh, look, there's some like purple that fell down there. Fun times. Apparently, I was all sorts of confused this morning, and I hit timers on my meds because I hit like two of them. So I'm like, why is that going off? I already took my meds. There we are. Okay, so the next one is hello people that are joining. I appreciate, like, I don't know what it was about the past hour, but just nothing got through. Okay, so we're done with box four, as we established earlier. So now we've got everything box three. I had to flip over in my little list of shit. So box three, yay! Nope, not that one. Yeah. Diamine, Oxford Blue. We've in now the remaining boxes. It's going to be a mix of shit I've done already, I've reviewed already, and stuff I have not, because like all that was new ink samples I brought in over the last couple months. I didn't have another like box for it, so they just went in the empty slots in the old boxes. So this is like a hodgepodge of stuff I've already reviewed and stuff I haven't in like no real order. Yeah, we've got Diamine Oxford Blue. We're now in the what was it? There was an ink sample Palooza that Goulet did in like summer 2017. I ordered a shit ton of ink samples. That was the start of like a really bad ink sample problem. Because like basically before this, I had like two boxes of ink samples, and then that started growing three more boxes of ink samples within the course of like a year that I acquired. Like, I over doubled my ink collection in a year. Yeah. So this is Diamine Oxford Blue. Which I think I got this sample because I was looking into having, like, a purse, like a Kaweco purse pen or something, and, like, a pack of cartridges in there as, like, backup or something at that point in time. And this was one of the contenders because that diamonds come in standard international carts. I'm getting much better at filling adequately from a Goulet sample. It's not really that hard. The issue is when I've already like used a quarter of it, that's when it gets dicey. I'm not really having issues with the ones that I haven't touched. Just gotta make sure not to fill that Custom Heritage 92 all the way, because that shit can hold a lot of ink. That's why I bought it. Like literally the whole point, I was like, it was between the Custom Heritage 92 and the Custom 74. And I basically wanted a not cartridge convert. I wanted a piston filler gold nib. that was, or piston filler, like, Western extra fine, Japanese fine. And this was the option. Also, I kind of wanted gold nib, too. But, yeah. And I'm like, well, it's that. And that's about it, because everything else in that price range is cartridge converter, because I wanted the ink capacity.
Okay.
Not even spelling, like just straight up handwriting. As you can see, it's hard to even tell that this is a blue ink in the writing. It's like a super dark blue. Basically navy. got really nice flow. The other one had really nice flow too. Like, I was just like, oh yes, this ink is a pleasure to use. It's basically came down to, did I enjoy the color or not? Last one, like I said, better than Schaefer Purple. Still not my speed. This one is a lot darker than I was anticipating. Yep, super dark. If that's what you're looking for in a blue ink, this is a good one. And it's cheap because it's diamine. Thank you. You want a nice, really dark blue. Like navy blue. This is a good ink for you. Got great flow. This has got some really nice shading to it, actually. I wasn't expecting that. That's really pretty. Ooh, it's very windy outside. Hi, you're fine. Okay, yep. Just a really nice dark blue. This is not what I was expecting. Don't know if I want a full bottle of it. I could see using this as like cartridges for an emergency pen, though. I can really see that. Because that color is going to be acceptable to pretty much any forms you have to fill out. There's some salty lawyer speak going on in this article. Okay. About average feathering. It's not horrible. It could be better. That bleed through is not bad. This might be for you students out there who want something cheap and something that your teachers will not yell at you for having, so it's like black or blue acceptable. And it works on shitty paper, especially for us Americans. This might be a really good one for you. Okay. We're gonna have one more ink today, because my schedule, like, I like to have a certain amount of lead time with reviews, so I'm not like scrambling to do them, and when they post, that lead time is off where I'm like right at the edge of not, like, I'm at that scramble point where it's like, oh, by the time I finish all my reviews, I have none left in the bank to post. So I don't have any lead time. I usually like to have about a week's lead time, like, between when I write them and when they'll actually run out. So the last 2 weeks I've done an extra ink review each day to give myself that extra bump. So next week we'll be back to two. Yeah. Okay, so I'm putting this away, and then I will go back, and I'm gonna go leave to go rinse pens again. I will be back. Hello, I'm back. Stay everything. There we are. Okay, so last one we have in the pile is the Atramentis Petrol. And I think this is like a greenish thing. Let me see if I can find this swatch. This is gonna take a little bit. There it is. I found it. This is what color I thought it was. It's like one of these, like, greens with more than a hint of blue. So yeah, it's right by Marine Green, Emerald of Chavor. The other side I've got Colorvers Photon, R&K, Smarmagodron. These are both a little bit brighter. This is actually kind of like mid-ground between the brighter and the darker. Yeah. It's not coming across too well in this webcam. This webcam hates this sort of family of color. It doesn't like to represent them accurately. Oh, and just FYI, while I was cleaning pans, I also popped a frozen pizza in the oven, so I'm probably gonna have to get up that pause halfway through the stream to go fetch pizza out from the oven so I don't have a burning dinner. Yeah, because like I said, I'm basically in the midst of comps. I was like, I don't have time to fucking cook food. Normally I spend my days off, which is, today is one of my days off. Doing like lots of like maintenance things, which includes cooking a bunch of food for me to just like live off of during the week. And I'm like, I don't have time to spend all day Thursday and Friday cooking like I normally do, at least a substantial part of it. So we're buying easy food at the grocery store, like frozen pizza, SpaghettiOs, cans of soup, stuff for making just sandwiches, like a bologna sandwich, little fruit cups, like bananas, like easy things. I almost bought stuff for banana pudding, and then I was like, hold up, I don't have time to make no banana pudding. Even though it's fairly easy, I don't have time to do that. I'm at the level this week where it's like, oh, like a box of cereal. I normally don't go for box cereal because it's expensive and not as filling, but I'm like, I don't have fucking time for anything else. Plus, Kellogg's is doing this like promo. They have like a new like middle size box of cereal. They have the regular size, they have the family size, which is giant, and then they have this new large size for people that want more than your standard box, but they don't want a full family size. And because they're promoting it right now, it's like super on sale. Like it's on sale, and then Kroger has an additional coupon on top of it, so you can get a box of like Kellogg's brand cereals that's substantial for like $1.50. That is like cheaper than the Kroger store brand stuff. So I was like, don't mind if I do have me some corn pops. Because that's some shit that, like, there is no Kroger equivalent. So it's either pay whole hefty price or catch it with it. It's super on sale. Oh, this is also like almost a perfect match for this pen color as well. This family does tend to do that. This color family of inks, I should say. Where was I even in the article? This is really pretty, especially in the wet pen. So I don't know what it is, but it's feeling weird using it on this paper in particular. I can't tell if it's dry or like slippery. Like it seems like I've got Like the ink just won't adhere to the page. Heck, you are. Okay. So I'm not quite sure what to make of that, what to call that. And I'm not experiencing it in the wet pen, so it might just be that it's dry, but it's dry in a weird way. Be right back. I gotta go fetch pizza from the oven. It needs another couple minutes. Isn't that exciting? Life with pizza. Yeah, no, it feels slippery in this one too. It's weird. Wonder if it's the paper. We'll see, because it didn't feel like that in the Tomoe River, but Tomoe River like behaves well with everything. What am I doing? Yeah, it doesn't feel slippery like that on the Rhodia. Just a Kikuyu thing. Weird. No, it does feel kind of slippery. Yeah. And it's like causing feathering issues and all that fun stuff. Oh. Cool. Gotta go get the pizza again. Okie dokie. Pizza is out of the oven. We've got one thing left. So basically, while it cools, I shall do the last of these inquiries and then go eat pizza. This has turned out to be great timing. slippery on this one too, and it really shouldn't. So that's a like weird chemistry thing. Like, it's also like kind of randomly skipping. And I know it's not the pens because I was just writing with the pens. It's not hand oils because I'm writing with my same hands. And like, it's, I don't know, it's weird. I want to get this out of my pens. For as much as people shit on noodlers, I've never had that. Of the noodler things I've reviewed, I haven't had one that I'm like, I want to get this out of my pens. This is weird. But I've had that for, this is now the second Atramentis? That I'm like, I don't know about this. Chemistry seems off here somehow. Okay, so that's it. That's all my inks. Might be back on later today, probably tomorrow, to do a bunch of scanning. So if you want to join me in scanning all the inks, you're welcome to. If I actually end up going on and doing that, I might just do it later tonight while talking with my brother. Just be like, hey, I know we're chatting, but I also am doing ink review scans. It's very important. Okay, so that can go away. Like I said, I'm gonna do this and then go eat pizza. You can just, like, you've, like, been able to, like, watch the sun, like, kind of go down and the weather kind of gets shittier outside as, like, the light has come less from over here, like, the windows over here, and more from over there, which is where the overhead light is. An introduction to the lighting in Sarah's apartment. You know, logically, it would make more sense. Well, actually, no, I've tried a whole bunch of different arrangements, and none of them, like, I need, like, separate, like, diffuser lights, like, back behind the, like, all around the laptop to get good lighting here at night. But, yeah. So, cool. Thank you for joining me. Like I said, it's exciting. We're into this box now. Next week is going to be 2 Faber-Castell inks. Graph on Fiber Castell, Hazelnut Brown, and Deep Sea Green. Yeah. Again, from that 2 years ago Ink Symbol Palooza from the Goulets. But yeah, thank you for joining me. I'll see you next week. If I'm not, like, I might be in, like, deep in comps studying because the test is next Friday, so I might just be like, ah, cram. But I might tweet about it. I don't know. I might not be here next week, but I'll definitely be here in 2 weeks. Anyway, have a good night. Bye.